Remember when I talked about the heart necklace event and who wouldn't want this impressive necklace for their classes?
You find this reward from this upcoming limited time event. An impressive award that doesn't have an expiration date. Who wouldn't want that?
Well, screw this shit. Some of us will be very disappointed. This event involves using the Gachapon machine, which cost us $1.50 per ticket. And knowing this game RNG, one could say it's gonna take a while to acquire the desired heart. Know this, there is not one but 5 hearts to choose from, and each heart varies on which job you're going to have the necklace on. They don't call the magician magician, they call it judicacy. What? Or was it judiciary or something like that? How do you even pronounce that? So who would really be invested in this event? Well, if we know the end result of the necklace, this necklace has a high base stat to begin with. I would definitely say if people who desire more damage is willing to spend more money on the character's improvement, I guess there's a term for that: pay to win. And it is what it is. Maple Story is not free to play to begin with as well. If I could recall, there are past events that work similar to this, requiring purchase of a cash out item to unlock or unbox this chest item, such as the monster box like right now. And honestly, I really thought that this event could help the weaker non-money spending player to assist in their character damage growth. And I thought I was one of the few, or rather I was one of the few who even went through the process. I mean, I even went and researched every single shit about it, and I even indicated it's free over there. Well, yeah, so after looking through the events and the patch note, I realized there is no methods, or rather no free to play methods to get the hearts without paying. So whatever happened to these 3 famous quest mechanics that MapleStory loves to give us? Like, if you don't know what I mean, it would be these 3 mechanics called the jump quest, fetch quest, or kill quest. That means you clear the quest by you get the reward by jumping a certain obstacles, clearing obstacles and this kind of shit. Fetch quest and kill quest, I think you all are very familiar with it. And yeah, so all in all, to those who actually find this necklace worth the money to spend on, and you know, also think that you're feeling lucky, go for it. It's a recommendation from me. Support Nexon and support Azusoft, you know, to maintain MapleStory for us, the C server. And to those who want the item but you do not want to spend any money on it, there is alternatives for you to get it free to play. That will be the Hauntail necklace. I think if you can solo Hauntail, or you can get a party, go down Hauntail and get the necklace. I mean, that's all RNG, like based on luck, whether it will drop or not. And if you can get better, or rather, you know, improve in your character stats or whatsoever, you can actually go for Aquarium to get a Dominator's Pendant, which is, I think, is even better than a Hauntail necklace. Or even the Mark of Nahiren. If I'm not wrong, is this 20 man party quest for the Crimson Wood Keep party quest, I guess. You can go there and earn those necklace. Hold on, does it even exist? Thanks for watching the talk on MapleStory content. If you think I make any sense in whatever I said, then subscribe to show support, and vice versa if you disagree. Any comments for me, like, you know, any comments whatsoever, just comment down in the comment section. I'll try my best to answer them. Keyword, try. Well, time to go play hoops in my Rocket League.